Hey guys, welcome to the channel. If you're looking to buy a telescope, then you must have come across the Celestron NexStar 4SE and Celestron NexStar 130 SLT telescopes. Both of these telescopes are manufactured by Celestron, but they both are from the two different series of Celestron. Celestron NexStar 4SE is from Celestron's SE series, and Celestron NexStar 130 SLT is from Celestron's SLT series. SLT series of Celestron is targeted towards beginner to intermediate levels of astronomers, and NexStar 130 SLT is the top model from the SLT series. On the other hand, the NexStar SE series is targeted towards the beginner to advanced levels of astronomers, and 4SE is the first telescope in the SE series. Also, SE series is an upgrade from the SLT series. As there is a very slight cost difference between these two telescopes, many of you get confused about whether you should buy a 4SE telescope or a 130 SLT telescope. So in this video, we will compare these two telescopes and see which telescope is a better choice. Let's see the details of Celestron NexStar 4SE. This is the first telescope in the NexStar SE series. It's a Maksutov Cassegrain type telescope. It has an aperture size of 102 millimeters and a focal length of 1325 millimeters. Its focal ratio is 13, its highest useful magnification is 241 times, and its lowest useful magnification is 15 times. This telescope comes with two eyepieces, one is 25 millimeters and the other is 9 millimeters. The telescope comes with a computerized go-to mount, which has data of 40,000 celestial objects. The mount, which comes with 4SE, has a built-in wedge, which is helpful in polar aligning your telescope and very much helpful in astrophotography. The total weight of this telescope is 23 pounds. With this telescope, you can see the moon, planets, and star clusters, dark surface features on Mars, the ring of Saturn, and many faint comets and brighter asteroids. Let's see the details of NexStar 130 SLT. This is the top model in the NexStar SLT series. It is the Newtonian reflector-type telescope. It has an aperture of 130 millimeters and a focal length of 650 millimeters. Its focal ratio is 5. Its highest useful magnification is 307 times, and its lowest useful magnification is 19 times. This one also comes with two eyepieces. One is 25 millimeters, and the second is 9 millimeters. The total weight of the telescope is 18 pounds. This telescope has inbuilt data of 4,000 celestial objects. The mount, which comes with this telescope, is slightly less sturdy than the one that comes with the SE series, so sometimes it vibrates when you move the telescope, but it can be solved by using anti-vibration pads. With this telescope, you can see craters on the moon, phases of Venus and Mercury, polar ice caps on Mars, star cluster, nebula, and galaxies, and some bright deep space objects. So this is the difference between these two telescopes. Now, which one should you buy? The biggest difference between these telescopes is aperture size. 130 SLT has a bigger aperture. That means it collects more light than the 4SE. Also, 130 SLT has half the focal length compared to the 4SE. This means 130 SLT will give you a wider field of view, which will show you more objects in your field of view. This is good for observing deep space objects. The 4SE has a longer focal length and a narrow field of view, which is good for observing planets. When you are observing planets, you need higher magnification, and with 4SE, it is easier to get higher magnification. With 130 SLT, you can also get higher magnification, but you need to use Barlow lens and collimate it accordingly. When a telescope collects more light, the better images it gives, but usually there is always a slight amount of light that is lost and reflected. So in the SE series, the lens and glasses are coated with Celestron's StarBright XLT technology, which helps in absorbing the maximum light, so the images you will see will be sharper and brighter. So if you are someone who just wants to observe planets, then 4SE is a better choice for you. As a 4SE telescope has a smaller aperture and is limited to observing planets, there is a possibility that you might outgrow this telescope very fast and you'd be looking for buying a bigger aperture size telescope. As mentioned in the beginning, SE series is an upgrade from the SLT series, and the most important part of the telescope is its aperture. Bigger aperture allows collecting more light, ultimately giving brighter images. Also, with a bigger aperture telescope, you can observe deep space objects. 130 SLT has a bigger aperture and costs slightly less than 4SE. So if you are someone who is on a tight budget and wants a slightly bigger aperture telescope to explore planets and a little bit of deep space objects, then 130 SLT is a better choice for you. I hope this video helped you to understand the difference between these two telescopes to make a better buying decision. If it did, then give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more technology-related content. See you in the next video. Have a nice day, guys. Peace.